to Storytime at Home with the Livermore Public Library. My name is Miss Caitlin, and today we are going to use our scarves in the songs towards the end of Storytime. So please grab a scarf for those songs. Welcome, everybody. Let's begin today by singing Hello, Hello. It's a repeat after me song, so everything I say, you should say too. Hello, hello, can you clap your hands? Hello, hello, can you clap your hands? Can you stretch up high? Can you touch your toes? Can you turn around? Can you say hello? Hello, hello, can you stomp your feet? Hello, hello, can you stomp your feet? Can you stretch up high? Can you touch your toes? Can you turn around? Can you say hello? Good. Now let's get our fingers ready by doing open, shut then. Open, shut them, open, shut them. Give a little clap, clap, clap. Open, shut them, open, shut them. Put them in your lap, lap, lap. Creep them, crawl them, creep them, crawl them. Right up to your chin, chin, chin. Open up your mouth real wide, but do not let them in. Open, shut them, open, shut them. Give a little clap, clap, clap. Open, shut them, open, shut them. Put them in your lap, lap, lap. Talk about our Livermore Reads Together Black History Month Person of the Day. Today I'm encouraging you to learn more about Katherine Johnson. Yeah, she was a mathematician. Mathematician. Do you know what her job was? Her job was to do math. More specifically, she did all of the calculations that helped figure out the best path for the rocket ships to take when they took the first people to the moon. Wow, such an important job. Now, back when Katherine Johnson was working and doing her calculations, the computers they were using were super big and super slow. It was faster to get super smart people like Katherine to do it instead. So she did all the math that helped put astronauts on the moon. Wow. Learn more about her in books like this one, and we have others in our catalog as well. So check those out and learn more about Katherine Johnson. What's this? It's my ducky friend. Hello, ducky. We're going to sing The Five Little Ducks, which is a great counting song, and learning your numbers and learning to count is the first step to becoming a mathematician, just like Katherine Johnson. So we're going to sing The Five Little Ducks. So we're going to start with five ducks on one hand and the mama duck on the other. Okay? The song goes like this. Five little ducks went out one day over the hills and far away. Mother duck said, quack, 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 quack. But only four little ducks came back. Four little ducks went out one day over the hills and far away. Mother duck said, quack, 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 quack. But only three little ducks came back. Three little ducks went out one day over the hills and far away. Mother duck said, quack, 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 quack. But only two little ducks came back. Two little ducks went out one day over the hills and far away. Mother duck said, quack, 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 quack. but only one little duck came back. One little duck went out one day, over the hills and far away. Mother duck said, quack, 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 quack. But none of her five little ducks came back. Now sad mother duck went out one day, over the hills and far away. Mother duck said, quack, 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 quack. And all of her five little ducks came back. Good job. Can you count to five with me? One, two, three, four, five. Five little ducks. Let's read a book. Today we're going to read 10 Black Dots by Donald Cruz. Donald Cruz has lots of really cool books. You might have read Freight Train. That was pretty popular. This one's all about counting. Gotta learn our numbers, right? What can you do with 10 black dots? Where do you see 10 black dots? One dot can make a sun or a moon when day is done. This book is all about imagining what you can do with the dots and the different pictures and ideas you can express. Two dots can make the eyes of a fox or the eyes of keys that open locks. Three dots can make a snowman's face or beads for stringing on a lace. Four dots can make seeds from which flowers grow or the knobs on a radio. Your radio might look a little different now, but you used to turn the dials to adjust the station and the volume, all sorts of good stuff. Five dots can make buttons on a coat or the portholes on a boat. One, two, three, four, five. Same number as our little ducks. Six dots can make marbles that you hold. Half are new, the rest are old. Seven dots can make the spots on a snake or stones turned up by a garden rake. Eight dots can make the wheels of a train, carrying freight through sun and rain. What do trains say? Choo-choo! Nine dots can make toy soldiers standing in a rank. Or the pennies in your piggy bank. Do you have a piggy bank? Sometimes they look like different characters too, but it's a place where you can put your money, your coins and your dollar bills, and you can save them for another time. Yep, and you can use the money later. Ten dots can make balloons stuck in a tree. Uh-oh, you don't want your balloons to be stuck. Shake the branch and set them free. Shake, 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 shake. We also don't want them to fly away, though. When you have a balloon, it's best to take good care of it, right? Count them. Are there really 10? Now we can begin again, counting dots from 1 to 10. So, help me count. 1, 2,
three, four, five. Goes up to five on this page. And the next page we have six, seven, eight, nine, and 10. Look at those 10 dots. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Good job counting with me. The end. Now it's time to sing another song. Let's sing The Ants Go Marching, okay? More practice for our counting, right? We're gonna count up to the number four, but we're gonna start with one finger on each hand. Ready? The ants go marching one by one, hurrah, hurrah. The ants go marching one by one, hurrah, hurrah. The ants go marching one by one, the little one stops to suck his thumb, and they all go marching down to the ground to get out of the rain. Boom, 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 boom. What comes after one? Two. The ants go marching two by two, hurrah, hurrah. The ants go marching two by two, hurrah, hurrah. The ants go marching two by two, the little one stops to tie his shoe, and they all go marching down to the ground to get out of the rain. Boom, 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 boom. What's after two? Three. The ants go marching three by three, hurrah, hurrah. The ants go marching three by three, hurrah, hurrah. The ants go marching three by three, the little one stops to climb a tree, and they all go marching down to the ground to get out of the rain. Boom, 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 boom. And what's after three? Four. The ants go marching four by four, hurrah, hurrah. The ants go marching four by four, hurrah, hurrah. The ants go marching four by four, the little one stops to slam the door, and they all go marching down to the ground to get out of the rain. Boom, 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 boom. Good job counting up to 1, 2, 3, 4. Now it's time to use our scarves for the next two songs. The first scarf song we're going to do is We Wave Our Scarves Together. We wave our scarves together, we wave our scarves together, we wave our scarves together. Because it's fun to do, we wave them all up high. We wave them all down low. We wave them in the middle. Because it's fun to do. Now let's throw our scarves. We throw our scarves together. We throw our scarves together. We throw our scarves together. Because it's fun to do, we throw them all up high. We throw them all down low. We throw them in the middle. Because it's fun to do. Good. Now we're gonna do one more song. Let's do Popcorn Kernels. Popcorn kernels, pop. Corn kernels in the pot, shake them, shake them, shake them, shake them, shake them, shake them, till they pop, popcorn sounds like such a yummy snack. Let's do that song one more time. Popcorn kernels in the pot, shake them, shake them, shake them, shake them, shake them, shake them, till they pop, till they pop. Good job. So that's it for
today's story time at home with the Livermore Public Library. Thank you for counting with me. By learning your numbers, you're one step closer to being a mathematician just like Katherine Johnson. Before we say goodbye today, let's sing one more song. We're going to sing, we clap our hands like this. We clap our hands like this. We clap our hands like this. We clap our hands with all our friends. We clap our hands like this. We stomp our feet like this. We stomp our feet like this. We stomp our feet with all our friends. We stomp our feet like this. We wave goodbye like this. We wave goodbye like this. We wave goodbye to all our friends. We wave goodbye like this. Goodbye, everybody. I'll see you next time.